Hello, my name is Christopher Gaither, and I want to thank you personally for joining us on New Life of Albany Revamped Youth Devotional Episode 5. I want to start out by saying that I hope everybody is being well, everybody is healthy and staying safe in the troubling times and the pandemic that we are in right now. I have a couple questions for you. Have there been times in your life when someone has tried to influence you in making a wrong decision? How frustrating was that, especially if that was someone that you trusted that was in an authoritative position, a position of power? It happens a lot nowadays. We put our trust in the wrong people, especially people that are in authoritative positions, i.e. the government, and we end up straying away from what God truly has for us. In Zephaniah chapter 3, in the first four verses.
My life is here, and I'll be a living sacrifice for you. You're a fire, the refiner. I want to be consumed. I want to be tried.
Pretty same as what we're going through right now. It describes the city of Jerusalem being away from God and being away from what God has called that city to be. And it states that there were people of judge positions, people of priest positions, people that were in positions of power and authoritative positions were straying the people of Jerusalem in a wrong direction. And it was upsetting God. But in verse 5, it states that God was there in the midst of all of those troubles, in the midst of all of those struggles, in the midst of all the turmoil, the trials, and the tribulations, and the hardship. It states that God was still there. So, I want to encourage you to never forget what God has done for you or what God has brought you through. Especially in the situations that we are facing now. Just because things are hard, just because people are dying in the streets, just because people are dying from this coronavirus, this COVID-19 pandemic, does not mean that God is not here. This is a trial. And throughout every trial, there is a finish. There is a overcoming hill. So I want to take this time to go ahead and pray. Jesus, God, I thank you, Lord, for this day, God. I thank you for your wisdom over our lives, God. I pray, God, that our hearts would never be hardened towards you, Jesus, God, but that we would always have our eyes open and our minds renewed towards you, Jesus, God, that your hand would just be the delivering factor, Lord Jesus, of all the situations that we are facing, God. Lord, I ask that your hand would be over our government, Lord Jesus, God, that your hand would be over people that are in authoritative positions, Lord Jesus, God, that you would direct them, Lord Jesus, God, to make the best decisions for the country, Lord Jesus, God, and for our world, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, that we must understand, Jesus, God, that whatever is going on in this world, God, you have already seen it, Jesus, God, from the very beginning of time. You have already seen this to be coming, Lord Jesus, Lord. I thank you, Lord God, for your wisdom, Lord Jesus, God, to be able to allow things, certain things to happen in certain aspects of our life, Jesus, God, because you know that at the end of it, it's going to turn us around to become a better person, Lord Jesus, God. Lord, I ask, Jesus, God, that you would allow your church to come together, Jesus, God, in these hard times, Lord Jesus, that we would begin to uplift you, Lord Jesus, God, that we would begin to draw near to you, Lord Jesus, because your word says that we draw near to you, you draw near to us, Lord Jesus. And we thank you, Lord God, for your grace and mercy, Jesus, God, because you have been so graceful and so merciful in our lives, Jesus, even though we are undeserving of it, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you, God. I thank you for your direction, Lord Jesus, God. I thank you for your guidance, Jesus, God. Guide our government, Lord Jesus, God, to make better decisions, Lord Jesus, God. Touch our presidency, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Touch our D.C. district, Lord Jesus, God, that your hand will be over that, over those facilities, Lord Jesus. You, and we just want to thank you, Jesus, for what you are doing in our lives, God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for the people that are being baptized in your name, God, and that are filled with your Holy Spirit, Jesus, God. We just worship you for that, Lord God. And we thank you, Jesus, for all the things that you are doing, Lord God, to draw us closer to you, Jesus, God, in the end game, Lord Jesus, God. In Jesus' name, I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Jesus. Wash us, Lord Jesus. Cleanse us in your blood, Lord. Make us new and make us whole, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. I really enjoyed my time with you all. Thank you for watching. We'll see you on the next one.
Take my life as a living sacrifice.